Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the next chapter, that is chemical kinetics. Now in thermodynamics we did, that is what are the spontaneous and non-spontaneous reaction. That is thermodynamics tells you about the spontaneity, that is the factor delta G tells you about the spontaneity, whether the reaction is visible or not. But it is not telling you about the kinetics or speed of the reaction. So in this chapter we will do what is the speed of the reaction, or you can say the branch of physical chemistry which deals with the rate of the chemical reactions, that is called as chemical kinetics. So in this chapter we will do rate or the speed with which the chemical reaction proceed. So chemical means chemical reaction and kinetics means that is rate or speed. Now in this chapter we will study about the factors affecting rate of reaction. So there are number of factors, so we will do in details for the concentration, then temperature, how temperature affects the rate of reaction, then catalyst. So there are other factors also, surface area and all, so that also we will do. So we will do factors affecting rate of reaction, then we will do rate law expression, how to express the rate law or the rate of the reaction. Then we will do two more terms, that is order and molecularity, and in order we do zero order and first order reactions. So before starting we should know about the few things, that what do you mean by rate. So what is rate? Rate is the change of any quantity with respect to time. So if you observe any change in the quantity with respect to time, then what do we say? We say the rate of that particular change. So now here in the chemical kinetics we will study about the rate of chemical reaction, and in rate of chemical reaction what change or in which quantity change we will study. We will study about the change in the concentration if the reactants are in aqueous solutions or aqueous medium, and if they are in gaseous medium then we observe the change of their pressure. So in case of gases we observe the change in pressure, whereas in the aqueous solutions or the aqueous medium we used to see the change in concentration of what, that is of reactant and product with respect to time. So we will see change of concentration or change of pressure of reactant or product with respect to time, that is called as rate of reaction. Now next is types of rate of reaction according to their speed or according to their rate. So according to the speed or rate of the reaction, they are divided into three categories: very fast, moderate and very slow. So what are very fast reactions? So the reactions which occur in fraction of seconds, so which occurs in fraction of second, they are called as very fast reactions. And in this fast reactions, all ionic reactions, so ionic compounds in aqueous medium, what they do, what they give? They give very fast reactions. For example, you have done in 10th also. For example, if we are taking NaCl and if we are mixing silver nitrate solution to it, then what is there? Immediately we will see the AgCl white color precipitates. So this reaction occurs in fraction of second, that's why we immediately see curdiness or white PPTs. So ionic reactions, they are very fast. And very slow, which take large time to complete. For example, simple example is rusting of iron. So rusting of iron is very slow process, it will take few days to occur. So that's why it is very slow reaction. And in between very fast and very slow, there are moderate reaction or moderate speed reactions. So what are these reactions? These are reactions are the characteristic of covalent compounds or molecules. That is covalent compounds. For example, if we are taking any organic compounds which are covalent in nature, if we just see those reaction, we have to slightly heat them to fast the reaction. So those kind of reactions, they occur at moderate speed, not very fast, not very slow, they are in between them, they are moderate reactions and they are given by the covalent compounds. Now next is how to express the rate of reaction. Now how to express the rate of reaction? For example, we are having any example, that is R is a reactant which is changing into P, that is a product. Now we can tell the rate of reaction with respect to reactants or with respect to products. Now we know that initially there are only reactants and no products, and with passage of time concentration of reactant keep on decreasing as they are converted into products, and concentration of products keep on increasing. So if we are expressing in terms of reactants, then what is the rate of disappearance of R? How fast the reactant disappears or consumed, that is equal to decrease in concentration of R in a given time interval. Now we know that decrease in concentration in a given time interval, for example, if we start from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to t, if we observe the change in these two intervals, then what is the time interval, that is t minus final time is t, initial time is 0, and this is the final concentration, this is the initial concentration. Now we know that final concentration of R will be less as compared to initial concentration, because initially only the reactants are there, and with passage of time their concentration keep on decreasing, so final concentration will be less. So if we take their change, that is final minus initial, then sign will come out to be negative. But we know that rate of reaction is always positive, so what we have to do, we have to put sign of negative in front of the change in concentration of the reactants. So we express it, that is minus delta, that is change in concentration of reactant, delta t, that is with change in concentration, that is with change in time, or you can say time interval. Same way we can express the rate of formation, we can express rate of reaction in with respect to products in terms of rate of formation of products, at products will be formed with time. So this is given by increase in concentration of products in given time interval. So in the same way, it is equal to final concentration minus initial concentration over t minus 0, which is the time interval we have taken, that is 0 to t. And here final concentration of product will be more as compared to the initial concentration, as initially product will be 0. So what will be there? So here we just express as delta change in concentration of P product over time interval, that is delta T. Now we can express rate of reaction. Now rate of reaction will be equal to minus delta R over delta T, and this is also equal to delta P over delta T, that is change in concentration of product. We can say rate of formation, rate of consumption of reactant with time is equal to rate of formation of product with respect to time. Now what will be the units of rate of reaction? They will be moles per liter per second, or moles per liter per minute if it is taking place in aqueous medium, and if the reactants and products are gaseous, they are in gaseous state, then we take pressure. So we will say atmosphere per second or atmosphere per minute if we express pressure in terms of atmosphere. Now there are a few examples. For example, if we take a simple reaction in which nitrogen is combining with hydrogen to form ammonia. Now first step, in order to find out rate of reaction, we have to balance this equation. So it is N2 plus 3H2 gives you 2NH3. Now we can express it in three ways, that is rate of consumption or disappearance of nitrogen, that is will be equal to minus delta change in concentration of nitrogen with time, or you can express it in the rate of disappearance of hydrogen or consumption of hydrogen, that will be equal to negative delta H2 over delta T. So both these terms we have to place negative sign, as this concentration, if we take final minus initial, it will come out to be negative. So make it positive, to make it positive, to make the rate of reaction positive, we have to put the sign negative in front of them. And rate of formation of product, that is ammonia, which is equal to delta NH3, over delta T. Now we have to write the rate of reaction with respect to each reactant and product. Now we know from this reaction that 1 mole of nitrogen combines with 3 moles of hydrogen to form 2 moles of ammonia. Or you can say 1 mole of nitrogen decomposes to form 2 moles of ammonia, or 3 moles of hydrogen disappear to form 2 moles of ammonia. Now you can say disappearance of hydrogen is thrice as the disappearance of nitrogen. Now if we write here the rate of reaction with respect to each reactant and product, then we have to express it like this. Here we have to consider stoichiometric coefficients of each reactant and product. Now here stoichiometric coefficient is 1, so we can simply write here minus delta N2 over delta T, that is change in concentration of nitrogen over time or disappearance of nitrogen with time. That will be equal to, here we have to take reciprocal of the stoichiometric coefficient, that is 3, so we have to take here 1/3, that is 1/3 delta H2 over delta T, and we are here in order to equate we have to take 1/2 delta NH3 over delta T. Now otherwise we don't take, but if we want to take rate of reaction and we have to equate all the things, then we have to divide the stoichiometric coefficient here with the each reactant or product. Now if I will take another example, for example sulfur dioxide plus half O2 gives you 2 sulfur trioxide, so rate of reaction that will be equal to minus delta concentration of sulfur dioxide over delta T, which is equal to minus of 2. If we take reverse of that, that will be 2 delta O2 over delta T, which is equal to, here we have to take 1/2 delta SO3 over delta T. So we consider here stoichiometric coefficients, so we have to take 1 by stoichiometric coefficient while expressing the rate of reaction with respect to each reactant and product if we want to equate them. Now next thing is, there are types of rate of reaction. So there are three types of rate of reaction. First is average rate, then instantaneous rate, and third is the initial rate of the reaction. So today we will do average rate and instantaneous rate. Now what is the average rate? Average rate is the rate of reaction when we are taking time interval to be finite. When we are taking finite time interval, then the rate measured will be average rate. Now for example, if you are having reactant which is changing into product. Now we can explain it graphically how. If we plot a graph between the concentration of reactant and the time. Now we know at time t is equal to 0, concentration of reactant will be maximum. And with increase in time, concentration of reactant will keep on decreasing. Now we take two time intervals, for example at time t1 if the concentration is c1 and at time t2 the concentration is c2, and we want to know the average rate between these time intervals, that is t1 to t2. So this is the time interval, finite time interval, in which we want to find out the rate of reaction with respect to reactant. So as the time interval is finite, so this rate will be average rate. Now this average rate will be given as minus of change in concentration of reactant with time interval, that in the time interval t. Now which will be equal to minus of the concentration c2, which is final concentration, minus initial concentration, that is c1. Now C1 is the concentration at T1 time interval, C2 is the concentration at time interval T2, and C2 is less than C1. So we will divide it by T2 minus T1. Now as this comes out to be negative, so we are putting the sign negative here so that the overall rate will come out to be positive. Now we will study the same average rate with respect to products. Now what is here, we are plotting the graph between concentration of products and with the time interval. So what is there, initially there is no product, so at time t is equal to 0 there is no product formed. Now as the time increases, the concentration of product will keep on increasing. Now for example, we are again taking two intervals t1 and t2. At time t1 concentration is c1 and at time t2 concentration is c2, and here c2 is greater than c1. Now average rate will be again written as delta p over delta t, which is given by c2 minus c1 divided by t2 minus t1. As this time interval from t2 to t1 is finite, so the rate formed, that is called as the average rate. Now next is the instantaneous rate. So what is the instantaneous rate? If this delta t approaches to 0 and we express it by the term dt. If delta t approaches to 0, then what is there? We express it by delta dt, and this is called as instantaneous rate. Instantaneous rate means that is the rate of reaction at a particular instant of time. Particular instant of time, that is delta t approaches to 0 at a particular instant. For example, if in this graph we want to find the rate of reaction at this particular time, that is t dash. Now at this time t dash, what is there? This will be the concentration, that is C. So how to find the instantaneous rate in a graph that we draw a tangent to this graph, and slope of this tangent will give the instantaneous rate. Same way, for example, we want to find at this particular time T dash instantaneous rate. So what is there? This is the point where we want to find, and this is a concentration corresponding to this, that is C dash. So what is there, how we find graphically? We will draw a tangent to this curve. So by drawing tangent to this curve, what will be there? We will find the instantaneous rate. We are drawing tangent to both these curves, and slope of this tangent will be giving you the instantaneous rate. So rate instantaneous, that is equal to the slope of the tangent. So we will take next things next time.